Guten Abend, sehr geehrte Damen und Herren. Eine Woche nach dem mutmaßlichen
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. One week after the suspected use of poisonous gas in Syria, a military strike by the West against the regime in Damascus is apparently imminent. The evidence is convincing, if not even compelling, that the Syrian government was involved, the Republican delegate and chairman of the Intelligence Committee Mike Rogers said in the US Congress. US Defense Secretary Hagel emphasized that the US were immediately ready for an attack. The US president is determined to act without a mandate of the UN Security Council in Syria. Fundamental human rights, like the right to be heard or the presumption of innocence, are simply disregarded in the case of the Syrian president Bashar al-Assad. We at Media Klagemauer TV want Bashar al-Assad to get a chance to speak. We will read this broadcast, an exclusive interview with Izvestia. Assad was addressed about the accusations of using chemical weapons. What can you say about this? Assad replied, "It is nonsense. First there are accusations and only then is evidence collected. Just this is what the most powerful country, the US, is doing." In other words, on Wednesday we were accused and only 2 days later the US government announced they would now start an investigation. How should they collect the evidence being so far away? We are accused that the army had used chemical weapons in an area which supposedly is under control of rebel fighters. But in this area, there is no definable front line between the army and the armed groups. Can then a state use chemical weapons of mass destructions in a place where its own troops are concentrated? This contradicts elementary logic. For this reason, such accusations are exclusively of political nature. And the reason is a number of successes of the government forces against the terrorists. Answering the question, will you allow a UN special commission to conduct an investigation in this incident? Assad replied, "As for the investigation of war crimes in Syria, we were the first to call for an investigation by an international commission. When the terrorists launched a missile with poisonous gas onto Aleppo, and that shortly after the numerous statements by the West that the government troops were ready to use chemical weapons, we called for an investigation by foreign experts. This position was coordinated with Russia. We wanted that the USA, France and Great Britain convince themselves that this is not our work, but rather our enemies are using chemical agents. They could have convinced themselves by means of specific facts and not only by groundless accusations." The Syrian government and the UN Commission have now aligned with a common approach in the investigation of the alleged use of chemical weapons. The result of the UN Commission will be presented to the UN. And yet they know, of course, that any result can be interpreted arbitrarily according to the preference of individual countries. Therefore, we do also expect that Russia will not allow interpretation of the documents in the interests of the American or Western policy at all. In addition, President Assad was asked about a possible military intervention against Syria. "Mr. President, what do the US have to deal with should they decide to attack Syria or even to invade the country?" Mr. Assad responded, "The United States expect a fiasco like in all the wars they have waged in the past, beginning with Vietnam until the present day. America has been involved in a number of wars, but could never achieve the political goals for which these wars were started. The USA could not convince their own people, consisting of many nationalities, of the legitimacy of these wars. In like manner, they have always failed to impose their own ideology on other countries. Indeed, mighty states can unleash wars, but can they also be victorious?" Dear viewers, these were excerpts from an interview with the Syrian President Bashar al-Assad. The full interview, including questions about his relationship with Russia, you can read in the following source. We keep track and bring counter-voices on the developments in Syria. Keep track too, dear viewers, and help us to uncover the human rights violations of the Western governments above all the United States. Help us to uncover how they justify the interventions by means of war on the basis of fictitious or unproven pretexts. We at Klagemauer TV will be back again tomorrow with the latest broadcast at the same time. Goodbye.